it's like we've just been discussing as well. This is important because some guys have a habit, they'll be looking. This is another reason for having your toes up. Your feet are a little bit closer into you. My legs are out like that, it's easy for Rob to figure for my ankles or figure for my feet. Alright? But just on that thing, if Rob puts one leg over mine, straight away, get the other one on it. If this one is in trouble, yeah, I use that one to get rid of it. Don't ignore it. Now, I've been caught in the past where people have got like a bizarre kind of ankle lock purely because they're just trying to get rid of you off the back. It's not that there's a technical thing to it, they're just trying to snap your ankle off or give you enough pain when you want to just let go of everything. So, again, this thing with the feet, really, really important. Okay? So as we're going to here this time, alright? If Rob starts to defend, if he starts leaning forward, for example, to pull away here, okay? I'm going to snatch this and lean into it to snatch him back. There's the deal. See? So lean in, snatch, punch the arm through, and feed this collar. So it's building on what we was doing earlier on. As soon as I've got that grip in, go. Straight off to the side. See this leg come out? This is a bit tight, so I'm going to let the grip slip a little bit. I'm behind his leg. Okay? What you do with your legs from here is up to you. You can just sit back, you can cross over. Setting this, Rob's countering, he's leaning forward. So I don't want to get into this where I just try and pull him. We're in the civil war. So I'm pushing forward and snatch. As this comes in, feed it straight in. The second I've fed, and this is why it's important to feed it in, you're more likely to get a good grip early. Then kind of just do this and then start fumbling because the guys are on it. If I can feed that in and get this grip, straight to the side, this leg kicks out. And I almost pull up to me and kick him away. Okay. What I've found, some of the guys are starting to play this now, and what's happening is they get in this position, they're doing this, and they're dropping the wrong way. So now you need to do a real big pull because this leg's stuck. So you've actually got to go away from where you're going to end up. Go this way, bring him on me. But see, I'm blocking his leg a little bit here. This will make it difficult for Rob to try and turn over it. Not that he'll want to too much because of the grip. This leg. So I'm using my foot to hook his legs. Keep him in position. Yeah? Yeah. Even if you're lucky enough to grip an arm and you're losing your grip, because this can happen, you can switch that to an arm bar. Sometimes, like I was saying before, you can go too deep with the choke and press it on your own wrist. So if you can reach through and grab the arm, just drop to the angle and take the arm away instead. Okay, one more. One by sit forward. Yeah? So we lean into him, this arm comes, and I can even cup his shoulder. See how quick that movement is? I lean into him first. I'm not going to sit here and try and pull him. He's expecting that. It's this tug of war thing. I don't want to get into the tug of war thing. Especially something stronger. So lean in as much as you can. Up the shoulder. So give him a little push forward first. Look how that's brought his chin up as well. This. In. Leave it under his leg. Now drop to the side. Yeah. Elbows on. I bring my hip up right there. Direction, I'm going this way to come back up. So I'm kind of going to 90 degrees just over. Yeah, I'm not getting this and dropping this way. It's all going wrong. Okay, if you go against somebody like Carl or Alex, they'll go, thank you very much, and I'll lay on your leg. So you'll fail from going from a submission that is stuck.